with that heavy duty. I just am excited about it. And I got some more good news when you were up here dealing with this. I talked to Kate, right? That's our we're dealing with the lease over, you know, at Foothills. And we just signed another 3-year lease at the same rate. So that goes to see the same work. Anyway, we're talking about intention, and wow, you know, it's like, this is a time of year everybody has intentions, right? You know, intention, I looked it up, it's like a goal or an aim or a plan, you know, for your life and stuff, and usually this is a time of year everybody kind of starts to look at it. So, anyway, what I want to talk about is a Fitbit, right? You know what a Fitbit is, you guys? Does everybody know what that is? It's a little watch band that kind of tells your steps, right? Tells your steps that you do. I've got 2,700 steps in today. My goal is 10,000. That's what they came with my age. After I put in my age and I put in my, you know, everything that I need to put in, it gives you like, okay, this is what you gotta do today. So it kind of is this intention of what, you know, your own, you know, exercise. And I hate exercise, right? You know, and my kids, they keep trying to get me to go to the gym. I told you, Bob, you know, I'm just not a gym person. You know, and so they got me this Fitbit. And the worst thing about this Fitbit, see, thing is that it's hooked up to their Fitbits and they can see me. I didn't know that, right? And so, you know, anyway, so I've got this thing and I'm gonna talk about it because I got kind of this love-hate relationship with it. It tells me when I'm sitting down to get up and move. It does. Oh, it's not hard to tell me how many when I sleep, you know. Yeah, it's crazy. But this is what I'm trying to get at, you know, I feel like this is going to go. Okay, so here I am trying to do this. I have this intention. I have to get 10,000 steps, right, to get my, you know, days in and then have my kids not yell at me and stuff. So anyway, what I'm doing now, and I found myself going up and down these stairs while I'm watching TV, right, so I can get these steps in and I can do this. So anyway, and I thought, well, what the heck, you know, I do walk. I'm kind of a walker, and I hadn't been for a while, so I thought, well, this will be perfect for this Fitbit. So I take Pepe, my dog, for his walk, and I'm looking, and I only have 5,000 miles in, you know, and it's getting late, and I got 5,000 to get in. I'm going, oh, wow, you know. So I'm in a mission, man. I'm on this mission to, you know, walk Pepe and get these steps in. So I get in. And we're going down the hill and everything, and all of a sudden we get to this park, and it's this beautiful park we walk. And, you know, Pepe all of a sudden just turns over on his, you know, back, puts his legs up, and he's just feeling the sun, you know. And I'm like, okay, just 1 minute, you know, we gotta get one something like this. And you know, it's gonna get me, he wouldn't get up. And then he turns over and he just sits, and he just looks at me. And I'm going, come on his leash, and tugging the leash, and he won't go. You know, and I'm getting stressed out. And I'm like, well, come on, and, you know, it's gonna get dark and I gotta get these steps in. And then all of a sudden I went, oh my God, I got it. You know, I got it, and I said, my intention, now think about this, this kind of works with all our life, is my intention was to do, they were wanting 10,000 steps, right? And I forgot the more important intention, right? My life intention is to be, right? To be, have a meaningful life, have a significant life. It's to be inspired. That's what's important, is the to be, right? So, yeah, it's important I got some steps in, but it doesn't matter if you have a healthy body, right? If you, you know, are so stressed out that you're, you know, getting cancer. Do you know what I'm saying? Is that your healthy mind. Here I was stressed out because I wasn't walking, and I had my head wrong in this. So my deeper intention always has been to live an inspired and a meaningful life. And in that moment, I was so stressed out, I wasn't either one, right? I might have got those 10,000 steps in, but I didn't get the deeper meaning of to be. So what I'm talking about here is your to do and your to be, right? You know, when you can always have a million things. I don't know if you guys do to-do lists, and I do that. But I always do a to-be list, too, because the to-be is more important. You know, it's how you are in the to-do. Does that make sense? While you're doing it, you have to have an underlying peace. You have to be there with it. You have to have a quality to what you're doing. As Judy was talking about, you said something about you weren't having the quality, I think, of your life. And that's what we're talking about. If I'm just sitting there trying to please this, watching my darn kids, what kind of quality, you know, am I having? Before, when I didn't have this darn thing, I would just walk and I'd look at nature. I didn't look at my steps, you know. Now I'm still going to do it, but I'm not going to be so, you know, anal about, you know, having to hit this 10,000, you know. So, you know, it's, Wayne Dyer says that the attributes of God, he calls them the faces of intention. And they are kindness and love and creativity, everything that you mentioned, beauty, wisdom, joy, those are the faces of love. Those are the things that are important in life. Now, exercise is important because you need a body, right? You have to have a healthy body to experience that sometimes, and it's harder to do if your body isn't important. But you have to remember, you know, that what's your purpose here? Why are you doing it, you know? Why are you doing it? I think it was Mother Teresa that said something about not big things, but you can do small things with great love. And that's what I'm talking about. Eckhart Tolle says something like that too. He says, whatever you're doing, do it with love. See, that's one of my biggest intentions, and it should be everybody's intention here, is that whatever you're doing, don't do it if you can't do it with big acceptance, big joy, or big love. Don't do it. You know, if you have to do it, you know, then do it with at least some kind of acceptance to it. And that's what I'm talking about. We make a vibration in the world. Each one of us make a vibration that goes out into the world. And that's how we make a difference in the world. You know, there was when I was young, I remember as a young mom, and I can remember thinking, I just want to make this big difference in the world. I wanted to do big things. You know, and so I went around, I was trying to volunteer, I volunteered here and I volunteered there, I'd take my kids to school, I'd fall into bed, and I remember speaking to someone wise one time, and I said, you know, I feel like I'm not, you know, making a big enough difference, I need to do something. And they said something like Mother Teresa said, and like Eckhart Tolle says, is whatever you're doing then, if you're doing it with love, you're fulfilling your purpose. You know, just walking to here to your car, if you're doing it in a peace of mind, you're sending a vibration out to the universe. That's why it's important, you guys. You know, that's why it's important. Everything that you think, everything that you, you know, your emotions, who you are makes a difference more than what you do. You know, we can go out and march out there, you know, and be mad as hell. I ain't gonna take it anymore. Or we can feel the vibration knowing that this beautiful planet needs our help, right? So we have a choice. That's why I say mindful marching too. We have to be together. And the more that we are together, the more that we come from our heart with whatever we do, we change the world a little bit more at that time, you know? And I want to kind of forget some of the talk I was going to do, because I was loving your talk and what you said, that, you know, that you went through so much this year. And I saw you go through it, and it was hard for me to see this. And here's what I know, and I'm reading a book that Judith had recommended by Tim Freak, I think. And he says something, I'm going to do a talk on it later because I love him so much and I'm so excited about what he's saying. But he says something like, this time, you know, since the beginning, 13.7 billion years we've been here, all of us have actually been here with Stardust in us, right? And we've accumulated time and wisdom up until this moment, see, this now moment. And so I'm thinking about you and all the stuff you went through. You accumulated all of this time and this stuff. And you accumulated wisdom, right? You accumulated this wise self, whether you think you did or not. You know, there was a lot you learned during this year. And you came to this moment, just like all of us, come to this moment right now that is a now moment. And in this now moment, see, there's no form, no past. It's just here, right? In this now moment, there's just, it's pure pureness. It's pure nothingness. And what that does is this moment of potential meets the wisdom that you bring to it. So in this moment is everything you need to be who you want to be, to do what you want to do. Does that make sense? You know, your past, the wise past that you are, everything you've been through, meets this incredible moment right now. I can do whatever I want to do. The past, see, the past is here, but only as wisdom that I take with me. You know, to me, I don't know if I'm explaining that right, but I'm telling you that we have so much potential in this moment because of what we've been through, because of the wise, you know, choices. Sometimes the not the wise choices. Sometimes we didn't make the perfect choices, but we learned. And I've seen it so much from so many of you. We've learned so much, and we've come to the moment to make a difference in our life. So every new moment is potential. It's pure potential that you can change your life. You know, I just love that. I love that. So our invitation is to live the grandest version of who you can be. Live the grandest version of who you can be. You know, we've been given the tools of time accumulated, which is wisdom, I think, to create something new in your life. And that's intention to me. It's a deep intention about who we want to be. And I'm not talking about just living your life with all these separate intentions. I'm saying live a life of intent. Make conscious choices. Make choices that are aligned with something deeper than your surface ego of what you think you need, but something that is so in touch and alignment with God, with spirit, whatever you want to call this incredible energy that moves through us, faith, whatever it is, you know, align yourself with it. Spend some time in the silence, you guys. Spend some time being mindful. That's why we decided we're doing mindfulness classes. We're learning how to meditate, go deeper and deeper so that we can get in touch with that power that is in each and every one of us, so that we can meet that moment of potential. We can meet that now moment where we can move forward and change who we are and change the world. There is nobody else better to do it than us. You know, this universe, this world has intention built in it, right? Just like a tree has an acorn has a tree in it. This universe has intention built in it. That means you have potential built in you. You have intention built in you. And in that intention is the potential to be anything, to do anything, to change this world. We can have an incredible, peaceful world. I do believe we will. I do believe we will create peace. Whether we live now to see it, I don't know. You know, but I know that we will. And this source that I'm talking about, this incredible energy that runs the universe, it's love. I'm sorry. I gotta say it every time. It's love. Love runs through every cell in your body. It heals you. It heals you. Physically. It can. I'm not saying it does every time. It doesn't cure you sometimes, but it heals you. You know? It loves us. It carries us. It gives us faith. And that's in every single one of us. You know? There's something inside of you. The scientists call it a future pole. And it's the move forward. It's evolution. It's evolution. Move forward. It's wisdom in each and every one of us. So, you know, set your goals to make it happen. You know, I think that's a good idea. I've always set goals and I love them, you know. But don't forget your original intent. See, you can have this Fitbit, run, you know, I can meet all these things. But it isn't important if I'm not at peace with the world. And that's what matters. That's what matters. So my prayer today and every day will be, may we have peace in our hearts, may we have peace in our home, and may we have peace in our world. And I'd like you to say it with me before I close. Peace in our hearts.
Peace in our hearts.
Peace in our homes.
Peace in our homes.
And may we have peace in the world.
And may we have peace in the world.
Thank you.